If you've walked around your neighborhood at night lately, taking out the trash, walking the dogs, there's a chance you've seen a streetlight that looks like this. In a sea of normal streetlights, there's one or two or sometimes even a whole block of them that are purple. It's kind of hard to miss, right? And the stranger thing is, it's been happening across America for years at this point. Since at least 2021, hundreds of local news stories, tens of thousands of TikToks and Reddit threads and whatever you call X posts now, have reported the phenomenon. And the purple lights just keep appearing all over the place, seemingly at random. So what's really going on here? Is purple light easier on the eyes at night? Better for pedestrian safety? Aliens? Actually, it's one big f*** up, and it comes down to how LEDs work, bad quality control, and good old-fashioned government contracting. So I'm gonna walk you through why America's roads are turning purple and how we can't seem to stop it. Over the past few decades, we've seen a shift in how we produce light. In the home, we went from incandescent bulbs to fluorescent to LED, and it's similar with streetlights. In the 20th century, every streetlight was a sodium vapor lamp. This used a mixture of neon, argon, and metallic sodium to produce yellow light. As early as the 1930s, sodium vapor lamps were used because the yellow light was able to cut through fog best. This idea of yellow light cutting through fog is something we still see today in off-roaders and wannabe toge runners. The longer wavelength means that yellow light doesn't reflect back off water droplets in the air as easily. The longest wavelength would be red, which is one of the reasons we use red lenses for brake lights. But for street lights, it's not the light itself that we want to see. It's what the light is illuminating. And for that to work, our brains need to fully understand what we're seeing, and that requires full spectrum light, like we get from the sun. So over time, manufacturers of street lights figured out how to increase the pressure in sodium vapor lights to create more full spectrum light. You're all familiar with the rainbow, right? Like every pandering corporate logo in June? Well, a full spectrum light is producing all of the colors of the rainbow, which, when combined, appear white. Higher pressure sodium vapor lamps were used in sports stadiums and large event areas. And if you were around in the 90s, you would have literally seen the quality change between low pressure and high pressure lights. The broader and more even the light spectrum, the more it resembles the light from the sun, which means it makes more sense to our brains, but also requires more power. So older neighborhoods might have had lower pressure sodium vapor lights, while new construction would have had the higher pressure white lights. The only problem with sodium vapor lamps is that they're relatively inefficient. For the amount of light they create, they also create a ton of heat. And when the goal is to create light, heat is basically wasted energy. They also scatter light in all directions rather than focus light where we need it. LEDs are much more efficient when it comes to creating light. You might have experienced this at home with incandescent bulbs versus newer LEDs. Back in the day, you couldn't unscrew a bulb that was on because it would be way too hot. Now with almost all lights being LED, you could just use your mouth. But really, don't do that for a number of reasons. Compared to incandescent bulbs, LEDs were nearly 10 times more efficient, with 90% of the wattage going to making light. Compared to sodium vapor, however, the actual amount of light per watt is not as big of a jump. But things like directionality and bulb lifespan, that's important later, were enough for nearly every city to start changing their streetlights out for LEDs. When this was happening, you could literally see the change. Streets that had once appeared orange or yellow were now bright white. Fun fact, this change was actually a real issue for the film industry. There was concern that period pieces in big cities would suddenly become much more expensive to shoot because the white lights made everything look too modern. And then making them all yellow again on set or in the edit booth would cost a lot. So okay, tricky film shoots are a pretty specific problem to have with changing how streets are lit at night. But I bet if you asked anyone you know what they think about LED streetlights, and I mean the functional, white, non-purple ones, and they'll say they hate them. The light is harsh, it's cold, and way too bright. And people feel that way not just because no one likes change, but because those lights aren't actually white. They produce blue light, like your phone or computer. You know, the things doctors say we're not supposed to look at before bedtime because it screws up our sleep. This isn't necessarily a bad thing for streetlights though. Blue light, or white light that skews blue in color temperature, boosts alertness and helps memory and brain function. All things you probably need while driving at night. But it's also that little truth That brings us to why everything is turning purple. So white LEDs technically don't exist. For an LED to make white light, it's a very different process than high-pressure sodium vapor or the sun. Remember the rainbow I mentioned earlier? The one from the Dark Side of the Moon cover? Well, that's the full visible light spectrum. The sun produces radiation at every wavelength in that spectrum, and a bunch of other wavelengths, including ultraviolet, but it's not producing them equally. This is called spectral distribution, and it describes the average skew of how light appears. If you're into photography, or just really into your light bulbs, you've seen this measured in Kelvin. Sunlight is about 5600 degrees Kelvin, incandescent bulbs are about 3200 Kelvin. This is why the color seems warmer, because the color temperature is colder. That's backwards and confusing, but let's not get into that. The point is that both the sun and incandescent bulbs were full spectrum sources with different average color temperatures. The trouble is, individual LEDs don't produce the full spectrum. They produce mainly one color. You got red, green, or blue, RGB. There are fringe exceptions, but as far as the materials available for something as mass-produced as streetlights, we've got these three to work with. To achieve white light in a monitor or phone, each pixel on your screen is producing equal amounts of red, green, and blue. To achieve white light in street lights, manufacturers use blue LEDs in a process called phosphor conversion. In simplest terms, the blue LED shines through a laminated yellowish filter made of phosphor and silicone that just turns it into white light. White light that is still a little too blue for comfort. And guess what? A number of manufacturers did a pretty crappy job making that filter layer, including American Electric Lighting and Acuity Brand Lighting, which together are responsible for tens of thousands of the defective lamps across multiple states. And over time, the filter either delaminated, developed cracks, or just completely fell off the LED module. If it fails completely, you end up with a pure blue streetlight. If it sorta stays in place, the blue light source interacts with the remaining pieces of the yellow filter and puts off purple light. That's why you see some people say they're turning purple and others say it's blue. It's both. And either way, it's a literal glowing reminder of the failures of your local municipality. But why did we only start to see this in 2021? Well, because the 2010s saw the first huge push by federal and local governments to swap out the old sodium lights for new eco-friendly LEDs. It turns out, many millions of dollars were spent on straight-up defective streetlights. But hey, at least money was cheap back then. So that's your answer. LED streetlights are turning purple and blue because of a simple manufacturing defect that, through political and economic forces, eventually showed up in every single state in America. Not to mention a number of other countries. When we started seeing these purplish streetlights, many people speculated that they might be better for night visibility or pedestrian awareness. And sadly, that's not the case. Actual blue light doesn't give you any night vision advantage over warmer lights. In fact, it makes it harder to see details and transition from light to dark. But there are other colors that could help with that. There's a small Dutch town that's known for its red lights. I'm not talking about Amsterdam. I'm talking about this. You can see it. The town has adopted red streetlights to help its residents see at night, and not just its human residents. The region is home to large populations of several rare bat species. If bluish streetlights help us see better at night because they mimic the sun, they also throw off the natural day cycles of bats, insects, and other animals. So the red LED streetlights provide illumination while reducing the bad effects on local wildlife. It also protects our night vision. If you've ever bought a camping headlamp or torch and wondered why it has a red setting, this is why. The longer wavelength of red light means that our eyes don't adjust as much going from light to dark. It's also the other reason brake lights are red and that you've never been blinded by LED taillights. The only problem with red streetlights is that we've already unanimously decided that a red light means stop. We are not ready for that level of change. Whether the lights in your neighborhood are red, purple, white, or yellow, the main thing is, at least they're there. Somehow, I live in one of the few neighborhoods in Los Angeles that doesn't have street lights at all. Let me tell you, it gets really dark at night. I take a purple one over nothing, at least. To date, there haven't been any reported cases of crashes or other bad situations caused directly by the lights turning purple. But I don't think we can feel good about our city spending all of that cash on lights that lasted less than half a decade, even if the intention was good. I mean, sure, LED streetlights are brighter and more energy efficient. I just wish we spent a little more time finding suppliers who were just a bit more competent. So where does that leave us, other than paying for a metric ton of replacement lights? Well, the good news is, in just the last 5 years alone, LED technologies have advanced to the point where manufacturers can get pretty close to the warm glow of the old lights. In fact, you might have already noticed newer streetlights that are significantly easier on the eyes than the first round of LEDs were before they started failing. But for now, just keep an eye out for the purple ones and let your local government know that that is broken. All right, you good? Good. I'll see you in 2 weeks. Thanks for watching.